It is Thanksgiving week, and we here at Judge Family Chiropractic couldn't be more thankful for every single one of our patients. We had an amazing food drive this year. I started this food drive about 16 years ago when I was walking into Christ Community Church. I noticed that they were blessing hundreds and thousands of families. They were filling U-Haul trucks filled with food. So I brought that concept back here to Judge Family Chiropractic. And every single year for the past 16 years, it's gotten bigger and bigger and bigger. Just to give you an idea of what we accomplished this year, last year we collected around 2,000 pounds of food. This year we surpassed that drastically and we collected over 3,700 pounds of food. It's the most we've ever collected in our history here. So again, thank you to our staff members that were weighing each and every pound of that 3,700 pounds, stacking it up, restacking it up. To our amazing, office members that brought these food items in, on Dolly. Some of you had families bringing it. Some of you went back to Aldi's and wherever you went to get this food five or six or seven different times. And I just want to give you the idea of what you are blessing about 150 families this year. That's over 400 mouths this year are going to be fed. Beyond that as well with all the food that we collected for Thanksgiving. So again, thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. We cannot thank you enough for making this such a great program.
Father saw in the days of old, would you do it again, do it again? All the stories told, all the miracles, would you do it again, do it again? You said consecrate yourselves to me. Time to sow and a time to reap. Won't you do it again? Do it again. There's a time to heal and a time to build. Won't you do it again? Do it again. You said consecrate yourselves to me.
Usually when we collect this food, it just goes out and we never see it again, but we're connected with the people that are putting this on this year, and seeing those videos and seeing those pictures come back just bring it to a new level for me, to see the people praying over the food and to see the people picking up their food to bring it home, to have an amazing Thanksgiving this year, just brings it again to a different level. So thank you so much again. I just want to wish you and your family a safe and healthy Thanksgiving holiday. And just remember what we've been teaching you. Have fun on Thanksgiving, but try to keep it to that day. Make sure you go move. We're doing a turkey trot. We're running 3 miles before Thanksgiving. I know some of you think that is crazy, but we love it. And it might be a fun tradition for you to start this year. Get up, get your family out there. You don't have to run the whole way, but there's a turkey trot in Batavia that I love. We're actually gonna be out of town this year. We rented an Airbnb in the middle of the woods in Nashville, Tennessee with some of our favorite people, and we're gonna do a 3 mile run before we indulge in the turkey festivities this year as well. So All right, switching gears. We've had some amazing events this year. The results that people get in this office, we just had a dinner, it's kind of just reigniting a passion for us. We do it every 2 months to do that personally and to help people like you understand the impact that we're having here with the information that we teach, all of the five essentials that people apply to their life. Steve came to the dinner and gave his testimonial. Scott came to the dinner and gave his testimonial. Steve came off of 13 medications. Scott already lost like 13 pounds, and he didn't even really try. He just started to eat right and move right. So reigniting the why you began is huge. People that get those best results are engaged with the events that we have. And yes, we do have a lot of events here, you know, but health, it's a big subject, you know, and a huge subject that we neglect most of the time. We put all of our energy and all of our effort into making money and our careers and different things like that. And you know, health goes on the back burner until we notice that that back burner isn't burning anymore. So I want to make sure that my prayer to every one of you is that you put health on the front burner and you're intentionally applying these things to your life every single day. And again, those talks and the nutrition things that we do and the events like the sleep seminar coming up in a couple of weeks, they're all designed to keep you engaged and to keep it at the forefront of your mind. So with that being said, I would highly recommend coming to our next event called Beyond the Z's. We're going to go through everything sleep. I've become highly intentional about my sleep habits and my sleep hygiene since I turned 38. As we get older, our recovery lessens and we need more sleep, and our sleep habits are hugely associated to not only the amount we'll recover, but how healthy we are, right? So we're gonna go through some amazing information. I would highly recommend getting into this book before you get to that seminar to give you a good foundation of what I'm gonna teach there and get, again, just solidify these concepts. But Matthew Walker, PhD, wrote a book called Why We Sleep. I read this probably 6-7 years ago, and it literally transformed how I sleep, why I sleep, the information behind all the things. And I think some people need that information to really take action is why it's so important. I remember growing up and everybody saying that, you know, we can sleep when we're dead. And he points out in this book that if we don't sleep properly, we will be dead sooner. Sleep is when our body repairs itself. Sleep is when, again, I talked about it in the last video, the brain washes out adenosine, which is our sleep hormone, and it makes us feel sleepy. So if we're not sleeping enough, our sleep hormone is still running around our brains, making us feel tired and groggy throughout the day. So we're going to go through sleep times. We're going to go through wake times, circadian rhythms. That just means circa is around or a circle. Dia is day. So around the day, we form sleep. So I've been reading in this book that actually we're predestined to be either a night owl or a morning person, which was mind-blowing to me, because we vilified these night owls because, you know, they're forced to wake up with the early birds, you know, to live in society, and they can't really fall asleep because of their DNA until about maybe 1 o'clock at night, and they're forced to wake up at 6 or 7 in the morning, so they're not getting enough sleep. So again, interesting concept like this in the book. I also learned, you know, every living thing has a circadian rhythm, even plants, and it's not just due to the sun, but it's due to the rhythm of the day. They took a plant that, you know, literally follows the sun during the day, and it opens up during the day to get the sunlight into the flower. They took it and put it in the dark room, and they peeked in a couple of times during the day when it was pitch black in that room, and the flower still opened up. So again, the memory in the plant knew when to open, which I think is fascinating. So we're all predestined to have these circadian rhythms within, and if we're not living innately with those rhythms, our bodies go haywire because of that. You know, I use certain devices to track my sleep, which is Whoop. I'll go into that in detail. I did a little bit of that at the cancer seminar, but we're gonna go into more detail with that at this sleep seminar. Just note that there's already 45 people signed up for this talk. We have only 60 spots available. We're gonna be having it right here in the office at 5:45 on December 5th. It's going to be about an hour talk. We're going to go through some, again, like I said, information, some products to help that helped me sleep beyond melatonin and natural things. You guys, just remember, just like we can't, you know, out supplement a bad diet, we shouldn't be taking things to sleep because it's not natural and it's doing a detrimental stuff to our health. So get there, make sure you walk up to the front desk and sign up. We will let you know when it is capped at that 60 people. Again, December 5th, it is the day before my birthday, so you get to spend the night, my birthday eve, with me. Thanks, guys, and we'll see you there.